Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa patronized in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The ceremony held at Isa Cultural Center in the presence of the fourth edition of Isa Award for Service to Humanity to EDHI Foundation in Pakistan. Upon His Majesty's arrival, he was received by the Deputy Prime Minister and President of the Board of Trustees of Isa Award for Service to Humanity, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa. At the beginning of the ceremony, the national anthem was played. Following the recital of verses from the Holy Quran, His Majesty the King delivered the following speech.
وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء ومن الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب وما أنفقتم من نفقة أو نذرتم من نذر فإن الله يعلمه وما للظالمين من أنصار إن تبدوا الصدقات فنعما هي وإن تخفوها وتؤتوها الفقراء فهو خير لكم ويكفر عنكم من سيئاتكم والله بما تعملون خبير صدق الله العظيم.
يتفضل سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى الخليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه بإلقاء كلمة سامية بهذه المناسبة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أصحاب السمو والمعالي والسعادة، ضيوفنا الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. كل اعتزاز نحتفي معكم اليوم بالنتائج الطيبة لأعمال الدورة الرابعة لجائزة عيسى لخدمة الإنسانية السائرة بخطوات واثقة وموفقة منذ أن أمرنا بتأسيسها قبل 10 سنوات، وعلى نهج يختزل ما آمن به والدنا الراحل طيب الله ثراه وعمل من أجله، فهو من تفانى طوال عهده في حمل لواء السلام وعرف بمناداته وسعيه لتحقيق أخاء شامل بين البشر، مرسخا بذلك النهج سمة التسامح الإنساني والقدرة على البناء الحضاري لشعب البحرين في كل الأوقات والظروف. ومن هذه المسؤولية الكبيرة التي نحملها اتجاه قائد وطني عظيم أنار بفكرة وعطاء مسيرة بلادنا وثبت بعزمه أركان نهضتها المعاصرة، تأتي الجائزة بذكراها العطرة وتوجهاتها الرحبة كخير دليل لاستكشاف المنجز الإنساني على الساحة العالمية الذي يعلي من قيمة الإنسان ويضيف إليه أبعاداً سامية ويجعل من خدمة البشرية والتضحية في سبيل حمايتها واستمرارها واجباً إنسانياً مقدساً. ويسرنا بهذه المناسبة أن نهنئ مؤسسة إدهي الخيرية بجمهورية باكستان الإسلامية الشقيقة على فوزها بالجائزة، وذلك نظير خدماتها الإنسانية الجليلة في المجالات الخيرية والطبية والإغاثية، مقدرين في هذه المناسبة الجهود الكبيرة التي يبذلها القائمون عليها لاستمرار المؤسسة في حمل رسالتها النبيلة، وكما تمنى لها مؤسسها الراحل السيد عبد الستار أدهي الذي سيظل اسمه خالداً بتضحياته، وسيبقى عطاؤه نموذجاً استثنائياً للعمل الإنساني الرفيع. ونود هنا بكل تقدير وإعجاب أن نشيد بجهود كل المؤسسات والأفراد ممن تقدموا لنيل الجائزة في دورتها الرابعة من مختلف بلدان العالم، وبالذات من تميز عملهم ونافس على الجائزة حتى مراحل التحكيم الأخيرة، وهو تحكيم نحرص على أن تتولاه نخبة من الخبراء والاستشاريين الدوليين مستندين في ذلك على أدق المعايير العلمية. ولا بد لنا في هذا المقام من التوقف بكثير من الامتنان أمام ما يقدمه رئيس مجلس أمناء الجائزة سمو الشيخ محمد بن مبارك آل خليفة من دعم لافت وإدارة متميزة لأعمال الجائزة منذ تأسيسها، مشيدين كذلك بدوره وإنجازاته المخلصة خلال مسيرة عمله الحافلة وأثناء قربه من الراحل الكبير. وفي الختام نكرر تهانينا لمؤسسة إدهي التي نتمنى لها دوام النجاح في تأدية رسالتها النبيلة، معربين عن شكرنا الخالص للجهود الحثيثة لمجلس الأمناء ولجنة التحكيم والأمانة العامة التي أثمرت عن وصول جائزة عيسى لخدمة الإنسانية لما هي عليه اليوم من مكانة مستحقة، ولتكون استذكاراً دائم التوهج للمسيرة المباركة لوالد الجميع صاحب العظمة الشيخ عيسى بن سلمان آل خليفة، تقمده الله بواسع رحمته وأسكنه فسيح جنانه. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak also delivered a speech on the occasion in which he expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for dedicating an award that truly commemorates the memory of late Emir Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa. He praised the contributions of the late Emir, his noble feelings and his outstanding deeds of charity and welfare. He said that the Isa Award today has become an international award that celebrates the late Emir's memory and outstanding human character. In the fourth edition of the award, His Highness expressed sincere thanks and appreciation for His Majesty's attendance of the event, which reflects the depth and richness of His Majesty's visions and the importance of humanity and its needs. His Highness added that the global society today needs an initiative that reflects the kingdom's deep-rooted respect for humanity and coexistence, and this award restores humanity to the individual, encourages charitable work, and embeds the values of openness, coexistence, and peace. He said that after 2 years of professional and transparent research and deliberation, the award has been granted to Abdul Sattar EDHI Foundation from Pakistan. He added that the EDHI Foundation is a project that deserves the award in appreciation nation in recognition of his ongoing humanitarian work in all parts of Pakistan. His Highness congratulated the foundation and commended the will of its founder, extending best wishes to the foundation's leadership for even further charitable deeds and humanitarian work. His Highness then expressed thanks and appreciation to Dr. Jamila Mahmoud, Dr. Ashuta Samanta, and Dr. Omar Izzat Salama, whose institutions received the Isa Award in its previous three sessions for their kind words and wishes for the award and its role in supporting the continuation of their humanitarian work. He also expressed thanks and appreciation to the Royal Charitable Foundation for its support and assistance to the Isa Award and thanked the guests who are sharing this ceremony today. His Highness then expressed thanks and appreciation to their excellencies, the members of the Board of Trustees, the jury, and the General Secretariat, along with all those who have contributed to the success of the noble humanitarian work under His Majesty's guidance. He wished the award continued progress and success.
أصالة عن نفسي وباسم مجلس أمنائها ولجنة التحكيم أعرب عن أصدق عبارة الشكر على تفضل جلالتكم من جديد برعاية هذه الجائزة التي يزيد حضوركم من أهميتها ومعناها التي تعكس غنى وعمق رؤيتكم في أن يتمحور عهدكم حول الإنسان وحاجاته، ومن هنا تظهر أهمية جائزة عيسى لخدمة الإنسانية، والتي ما هي إلا استمرارية واستدامة لحكم قائد ينبض قلبه على واقع خطوات شعبه القريب منه ومن وجدانه. ما أحوجنا اليوم في مجتمعات العالم حيث الإنسانية خجولة بحضورها ومكسورة بنسيانها إلى لفتة تعكس ما لمملكة البحرين من جذور في احترام الإنسان والتآلف الذي يجمل حياته وتاريخ مدننا ومجتمعاتنا. ما أحوجنا اليوم إلى جائزة تعود الفرد إنسانيته وتعمل على تشجيع عمل الخير وتأصيل قيم الانفتاح والتعايش والسلام، وهي القيم التي تفخر بها مملكة البحرين. إن لجنة التحكيم ومجلس الأمناء قاموا اعتماداً على النظام الأساسي للجائزة وبعد التشاور والدراسة وتوخي الدقة والحياد والإنصاف باختيار اسم يستحق أن يحمل جائزة عيسى لخدمة الإنسانية بنسخته الرابعة، ولم يكن الجميع ليتوصل إلى هذه النتيجة لولا حرصكم ومتابعتكم لسير العمل بهدف أن تأتي النتيجة لائقة بالجائزة وما تمثله لمملكة البحرين من مثل إنسانية عليا. إن قرار مجلس أمناء الجائزة وبناء على ما توصلت إليه لجنة التحكيم بفوز مؤسسها عبد السدار أدهي الخيرية بجمهورية باكستان الإسلامية بعد عامين من البحث والاستفسار والشفافية والمهنية في الاختيار يعكس توفر شروط الاستحقاق بالمؤسسة المختارة كي تحمل اسم الجائزة بنسختها الرابعة. هذا المشروع الأجدر بالفوز بالجائزة تقديراً واعترافاً وتكريماً لما قدمته وتقدمه من خدمات وأعمال إنسانية في كافة أنحاء باكستان، شملت إسعاف المرضى وإغاثة المنكوبين ومساعدة المحتاجين الضعفاء وإيواء المشردين وتعليم الأطفال الفقراء وإنقاذهم من الضياع والانحراف. أكدت كل ذلك زيارة ميدانية قامت بها الأمانة العامة للجائزة وأحد أعضاء لجنة التحكيم. نبارك للمؤسسة هذا الفوز، ذاكرين بالخير عزيمة ومثابرة مؤسسها رحمه الله، متمنين التوفيق للقائمين عليها نحو المزيد من أعمال الخير والعطاء. ونعرض عن الشكر والتقدير لكل من السيدة جميلة محمود والدكتور شوتا سمنتا والدكتور عمر عزة سلامة الذين فازت مؤسساتهم بالجائزة في دوراتها الثلاثة الماضية، وعلى ما عبروا عنه من مشاعر وعبارة طيبة اتجاه الجائزة وإسهامها في استمرار وزيادة أنشطتهم وأعمالهم الإنسانية، مؤكدين الحرص على استمرار التواصل معهم لتطابق أعمالهم الخيرية الإنسانية مع الأهداف النبيلة للجائزة. وأنتهز هذه المناسبة العزيزة علينا جميعاً ليعرب عن بارغ الشكر والتقدير للمؤسسة الخيرية الملكية لدعمها ومساندتها للجائزة، والتوجه بالشكر لضيوفنا الكرام لمشاركتهم لنا حفل التكريم، كما أقدم الشكر لأصحاب المعالي والسعادة أعضاء مجلس أمناء الجائزة ولجنة التحكيم والأمانة العامة وكل من أسهم في إنجاح عملنا الإنساني النبيل في ظل توجيهات جلالتكم السديدة والموفقة بعون الله. ويبقى أن نتمنى الاستمرارية للجائزة التي تشرق صفحة مضيئة في كتاب تاريخنا المعاصر الذي يولي الإنسان أولوية ويضع مملكة البحرين في أول الدول المنحازة للإنسانية بما فيها مشاعر وحقوق، استجابة لدعوة من عيسى بن سلمان لعالم أجمل يعمه السلام والإخاء والطمأنينة. وفقنا الله لما في خير الإنسانية جمعاء، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
نشاهد الآن فيلماً وثائقياً بعنوان شعلة لا تنطفئ حول مسيرة صاحب الجائزة سمو الأمير.
His Majesty the King watched a documentary film on the biography of late His Highness Sheikh عيسى بن سلمان آل خليفة.
لدى الفائزين.
وعليه فقد قررنا تخصيص جائزة تحمل اسمه الكريم، جائزة عيسى لخدمة الإنسانية.
عيسى ستبقى دائما، ستبقى دائما نورا مضيئا للأبد. عيسى
كل جانب مضيء يشهده العالم في تطور العلم والصحة والتعليم والتكنولوجيا، هناك جانب مظلم بسبب الفقر والمرض والكوارث والحروب. وبين هذين الجانبين من الحياة قادة عظماء وهبوا وقتهم وأنفسهم لخدمة أهداف نبيلة، فوجدوا في زحمة انشغالاتهم الكثيرة وقتاً لخدمة البشرية، متمثلاً في إطلاق جلالة الملك المفدى جائزة عيسى لخدمة الإنسانية تخليداً لصاحب العظمة سمو الأمير الراحل طيب الله ثراه.
كان أميراً وقائداً، أباً للجميع، أخاً للجميع، صديقاً لكل فرد من أبناء شعبه، وإنساناً كبيراً أحبه واحترمه العالم كله، فأعطانا من رصيده الإنساني ما سيبقى ماثلاً على مر الأجيال، فكان أصدق تجسيداً لما في البحرين من وفاء وتسامح وتحضر.
عيسى ستبقى دائما، ستبقى دائما نورا مضيئا للأبد.
The Isa Award was an important moment in my life that has given me that confidence and has given me the catalyst, rather the spark to not give up. Thank you so much to to the Kingdom of Bahrain, to my friends at the East Award Committee, for the people who nominated me, I really thank you, and I'm very, very humbled. I remain humble, and I hope that I will be able to continue my work.
I am so much honored when I received this award from the hands of our His Majesty, and the happiness and recognition my entire people in India, particularly Odisha, and particularly in my organization, Kit and Kiss, people have got after that moment of 3rd June, which I cannot repay in my lifetime to the people of the Bahrain.
هذه الجائزة لم يكن تأثيرها فقط معنوي على العاملين بالمستشفى، إنما كان تأثيرها أكبر وأكثر على المجتمع ككل، المجتمع المصري والمجتمع العربي. لما يشعر بأن مثل هذه الأعمال بتقيم وبتقدر من جهة متميزة وجهة معلوم أنها جهة محايدة وجهة لها اسمها ولها الاعتبار بتاعها على مستوى العالم، كون كل هذا يجعل المجتمع يشعر بضرورة أن يمارس الجميع العمل التطوعي والعمل الخيري خدمة لمجتمعاتنا العربية ومجتمع الإنسانية بوجه عام.
كان الأمير الراحل مثالاً وحافزاً لكل إنسان وهب نفسه لخدمة الناس، فاستلهموا من أهدافه وتبعوا خطواته لخدمة بني جنسهم والتخفيف من معاناة الإنسان.
وتتسع رقعة التفاعل البحريني، يتتعدى الأبعاد المحلية والإقليمية إلى الآفاق الدولية، فيجمعها بعالمها الإسلامي رباط مقدس لا تنفصم عراه، يشاركه آماله وطموحاته، كما تنطلق البحرين بخطها الواضح إلى إقامة علاقات مع دول العالم على أساس المساواة والاحترام المتبادل. وانطلاقاً من إيماننا الراسخ بأن الأمن والسلام هما الأساس الذي تبني عليه الإنسانية تقدمها،
وفي الختام نسأل الله أن تستمر هذه الجائزة في دعم وتشجيع أعمال البر والخير التي تخدم الإنسان أينما كان، مخلدة ذكرى فقيد الوطن والإنسانية صاحب العظمة الشيخ عيسى بن سلمان آل خليفة، طيب الله ثراه وأسكنه فسيح الجنان، إنه سميع مجيب. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
تلقي الآن معالي الدكتورة أوا ماري كورسيك، مستشارة رئيس جمهورية السنغال.
Then the member of the award judging committee, Dr. Awa Marie Kolesek, delivered a speech on the occasion.
Majesty, King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, King of Bahrain, His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, Crown Prince and Deputy Supreme Commander, First Deputy Premier, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure and an honor for me to address this exceptional audience. Your Majesty, the ISA Award for Services to Humanity is another example of your vision and generosity. And I would like to congratulate and thank you on behalf of all members of the jury. In a world where humanitarian crises, wars, conflict, natural disasters, poverty, and inequalities are the daily life of millions of people, your actions to highlight and encourage best practices of people helping others are appreciated and extremely important. The beauty of this award is its non-political aspect. Moreover, its real significance lies in the recognition of exceptional people making positive changes in their communities. I strongly believe that public recognition should not only go to superstars, but to those who make sacrifice to help the neediest through tangible action. Your Majesty, we express our sincere and deep gratitude for the trust you have placed in us to select the final candidates for this prestigious humanitarian award. It is my pleasure to announce this year's award goes to Abdul Sattar Eddy Foundation. Abdul Sattar Eddy, in his early age, was confronted to his mother's sickness. His experience taking care of his mother gave him the desire to establish a charity to help the poor all around the globe. Abdul Sattar Eddy started his adventure by buying a pickup he used as an ambulance. He called it the car of the poor. With his pickup, he made himself available to drive people in need to the nearest hospital. Step by step, he increased his potential in helping people. Later, his efforts led to the creation of the Eddy Foundation, Pakistan's largest non-profit welfare institution. The Eddy Foundation relies entirely on donation. It employs 3,500 people and has tens of thousands of volunteers across the country. The foundation provides ambulance services, free hospital and care centers, homes, rehabilitation centers, child adoption centers, and education services, among others. The Eddy Foundation's work covers all faiths, religions, and nationality without distinction. Over time, the people gave him the titles of Angel of Mercy and Father of the Poor. Abdul Sattar Eddy didn't forget the people outside of Pakistan. The foundation has carried out relief work in Africa, the Middle East, Asia, Eastern Europe, and the United States through donation of ambulances, food, financial resources, and direct assistance to refugees, victims of hurricane, cyclone, etc. Abdul Sattar Eddy was a hero to the poor in Pakistan and abroad. He was so loved by people from all social levels that official funerals were organized for him, and one day national mourning in Pakistan was declared. May he rest in peace. Congratulations to his wife and the children who have been always in his side and are continuing his tremendous work. Your Majesty, before closing, we would like to thank His Highness the Deputy Prime Minister, Chairman of the Board of Trustees, members of the Board, and the General Secretary of the Howard, who have made our work fruitful and our stay in Bahrain wonderful. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup.
صاحب الجلالة، أيها الحضور الكريم، لقد استحقت مؤسسة إدهي الخيرية بجمهورية باكستان الإسلامية الشقيقة الفوز بجائزة عيسى لخدمة الإنسانية في دورتها الرابعة بجدارة، كونها أكبر مؤسسة خيرية باكستانية معروفة على النطاق العالمي في مجال الخدمة الإنسانية، ويغطي عملها كل البشر من جميع الملل والأديان والجنسيات دون تفريق. تشاهدون الآن فيلماً وثائقياً بعنوان مؤسسة إدهي عزيمة رجل.
Then a documentary film on the award winner's achievements was screened.
Many people in life can't afford medicine. Some children, unfortunately, are abandoned. Others suffer from thirst and hunger. And others are lost amid their special needs without a shelter. While some face injustice from their own families. Most people in life dream about wealth, mansions, fancy cars, highly paid jobs, but few have different dreams for themselves, their children, and families. Nothing is higher than humanity.
لا شيء يعلو على الإنسانية.
The AD Foundation started with only 5,000 Pakistani rupees. More donations were received as people's confidence in the activities of the foundation grew. Abdul Sattar was able to start with a small dispensary, which today has turned into the Edi Foundation, the biggest non-profit social welfare organization in Pakistan.
मुझे एम्बुलेंस का बड़ा शौक था। मैंने पाकिस्तान में आने के साथ ही इदारा बनाया। फिर इदारे के साथों साथ मैंने एक पिकअप ली, उसको एम्बुलेंस बनाया, उसका नाम रखा पुअर वैन।
عبدل ستار ایدی فاؤنڈیشن پورے پاکستان میں ہر بڑے شہر ہر بڑے ڈسٹرکٹ میں ایمبولینس سروس مہیا کر رہی ہے جس میں پیشنٹ ٹرانسپورٹ سروس ایمرجنسی سروس ڈیزاسٹر سیلاب فلڈ اس میں تمام ایمبولینس سروس ہم مہیا کرتے ہیں جس کو شہر ہاسپٹل ہاسپٹل گھر پہنچاتے ہیں اس کے علاوہ پاکستان کے علاوہ پورے دوسرے ملکوں میں بھی جس طرح افغانستان شام میں بھی ہم ایمبولینس سروس مہیا کر رہے ہیں جس کے اندر ہماری ایمبولینس میں تمام ٹریکر سسٹم بھی نصب ہوتے ہیں اور ہر ایمبولینس میں وائرلیس کمیونیکیشن کے ذریعے ہمارے ہر بڑے کنٹرول روم سے اس کا رابطہ رہتا ہے جس سے ہم فوری طور پہ ہر کوئی بھی ایمرجنسی ہو ڈیزاسٹر ہو وہاں بر وقت پہنچتے ہیں
میری ایمبولینس تھی تو مجھے لوگ فون کر کے کہہ دیتے تھے کہ کوڑوں پہ بچہ پڑا ہے کتے کاٹ رہے ہیں اسی طرح تو میں اٹھانے چلے جاتا تھا میرے دل میں آیا کہ میں یہ بچوں کا کام کروں
The foundation operates food kitchens, rehabilitation homes, clinics for the mentally handicapped, and a hotline for missing persons. It provides wheelchairs and crutches for people with special needs, arranges free marriages for the poor, rehabilitation of drug addicts, as well as financial and medical support for prisoners. In addition, more than 1 million children were born at the AD maternity centers.
Since he started ambulance service, he used to find a lot of unclaimed people lying on the floor. He used to pick them up. He used to receive calls that there is a person, he's unconscious, but there's nobody with him. He used to go and pick that person and used to go to the government hospital. Government hospital were not keeping that unclaimed person because there was no attendant with them. So he used to bring that unknown person with him at the clinic. And he used to keep him. So that was the first shelter home he started. And then it grew because people used to call him and he used to go and pick them up.
The AD Foundation has the world's largest fleet of over 1,800 ambulances. It also provides 250 emergency medical service units and has trained 500 medical staff and 40,000 nurses. The foundation has buried over 200,000 dead bodies. Moreover, it has 28 rescue boats, one animal shelter, and 6,500 shelter homes. Furthermore, it runs 335 welfare centers and has saved 23,000 abandoned children.
Their name has become like an icon for the people to follow his footsteps. People trust him. The trust has been developed over 7 decades, 70 years. People have been seeing him working around day and night, 24 hours. There's no holiday for them. They are like angels on the roads. And we are thankful to Allah that we have been given with this EDs. And everybody who's working for the ED Foundation, for me, they are all EDs. I don't know if they are ED or not. They are all EDs. So we trust him and everybody in Pakistan trust him a lot.
Edi committed himself to a very modest lifestyle. He and his family lived in a two-room apartment next to the foundation building. Until Abdul Sattar died in 2016, the couple had not built their own house yet. For 50 years, the couple has engaged in dedication to alleviating human suffering and responding to every call for help without any discrimination in color, creed, or social status. Abdul Sattar believed that humanitarian work has no boundary and no religion. He believed that humanity is a religion by itself. He also believed that humanitarian work can prevent the world from wars and conflicts, so peace and love could flourish, and poverty and injustice could vanish.
يتفضل الآن سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه.
After that, His Majesty presented the award to Faisal Abdul Sattar Idhi on behalf of the foundation.
مؤسسة إدهي الخيرية ويتسلمها سعادة السيد فيصل عبد الستار إدهي مدير عام المؤسسة.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa.
Following that, Faisal Idhi delivered the organization's speech.
His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the distinguished Crown Prince and Deputy Prime Minister, honorable members of Board of Trustees and Jury Committee, ladies and gentlemen. It is with deep honor to be among you today in the Kingdom of Bahrain to receive the ISA Award for service to humanity. Thank you all for your warmth, hospitality, and generosity. I am also delighted to be among you today as a representative of EDI Foundation, which was honored to receive an ISA Award for the service to humanity in its fourth session. The prestigious award, which was established in honor of the late Amir of Bahrain, Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa, as a contribution to the Kingdom of Bahrain, to the world, to encourage humanitarian action and initiatives aimed at making the world a better place to live. More than six decades ago, in Karachi, Pakistan, Abdul Sattar Idhi, my father, started his humanitarian mission with a dispensary, then added an ambulance. Then he expanded the mission to almost every area of welfare and relief activities for the society. This humanitarian mission is providing ambulance service, shelter homes, coffin shrouds and graveyard, child adoption, missing person service, nursing school, not in Pakistan, but every part of the world where natural disaster occurred. The late Amir, which the award carries his name, will always be in the heart and memory of those people who will benefit from it. God bless him and rest his soul in peace. I must mention Mr. Idhi's quote that the key to success of every person that are punctuality, simplicity, always tell truth, and hard work. Upon those pillars, he spent his entire life serving the ailing humanity of the world. Only peace bring harmony among the people, among the nations of the world. In conclusion, I must express my thanks and appreciation to the Board of Trustees of the Award, the jury, and the journal secretarial for the effort and good work. I and my entire family on behalf of EDI Foundation are again thankful to you, Your Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, and prestigious ISA Award for service to humanity, which will go to Abdul Sattar Idhi and the nation of Pakistan. Thank you all once again. Thank you, Bahrain. Peace be upon you and God's mercy and blessings.
His Majesty the King was then bid farewell. The ceremony was attended by senior royal family members, the Speaker of the Representatives Council, President of the Shura Council, Ministers, Presidents of Representatives and Shura Councils, members of the Awards Board of Trustees, Governors, senior officers at the BDF, Ministry of Interior and National Guard, Diplomatic Corps, members, presidents of universities and charitable societies, businessmen, media personnel, and a number of representatives from the IDHI organization in Pakistan, as well as a number of invitees. His Majesty the King hosted a lunch banquet at Ghdebiya Palace, marking the ceremony held to grant the 2018-2019 Isa Award for Service to Humanity. Senior royal family members, ministers, the representatives of the Edhi Foundation in Pakistan, Faisal Abdul Sattar Edhi, and his accompanying delegation, members of the Board of Trustees of the Isa Award for Service to Humanity, and a number of guests attended the lunch banquet.
The Isa Award for Services to Humanity was established in 2009 by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, recognizing world changers amongst us whose tireless services through acts of compassion and innovation have helped in restoring faith in humanity and in producing a better world for succeeding generations.
It takes us and inspires us beyond any barrier. It's beyond race, it's beyond religion, it's beyond faith, it's for the human as individuals, how we serve them as individuals. And I think this is the essence of all things that are related to humanity. Even if you want to talk about religion, it has to be connected to this, connected to human and serving humanity in its essence. So today I'm so touched to see the activities that have been done by EDHI Foundation. They started with $32, and then we can see that an institution that carries about 3,500 employees and tens of thousands of people who are volunteering to the work, and how they are reaching everyone, reaching a sick person, reaching an orphan, reaching some people in the street who are homeless.
What we say in the Sustainable Development Goals, not to leave anybody behind.
Today was a demonstration of that principle in real life. The selection process goes to really those who at the end believe in serving humanity for the good of all of us.
It's a big boost for this sector of the world, sector of poor, orphans, needy, underprivileged, sick, who are getting the best attention from the leader of humanity, His Majesty the King, whose energy is, of course, comes from his extension to his great father.
The Isa Award is granted every 2 years to either individuals or organizations who have been selected through a grueling process by an expert panel of jurists. This year, in its fourth edition, the award honors EDHI Foundation and its honorable founder, who dedicated his life and that of all his family members to the service of people.
This will upgrade our human services in Bahrain. This will let us to see how the others are working by coming and attending this awards. So that we can see today that Pakistani, they win this awards. They started with very limited sources and they ended by they are covering whole area, which shows that this is the award itself. It won't show people how they connect and how they work together.
It's a great occasion. It's an occasion to tribute the late Emir, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa. During his period, we've learned a lot from him. His feelings toward the people were so strong, and that's why we call him the Emir of Humanity.
The EDHI Foundation just took my heart. I'm working with them for months, and we worked a lot to make this movie. We visited all the places that they work in Pakistan, and I was close to the things that they did inside Pakistan and outside Pakistan. And I was really emotional in every stage in creating this movie. Abdussattar EDHI, I wish I saw him before he died. Like, it was like he was my hero.
The award has been named after His Highness the late Emir of Bahrain, Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa, a great humanitarian and revolutionary ruler known for his empathy and compassion, aiming to inspire countless young people all over the world to look for innovative ways to change the world, play their role in service of humanity, regardless of race, color, or religion, bring beauty where there's none, and hope where there's despair. Since 2009, the Sheikh Isa Award continues to honor those who serve humanity, continues to restore our faith in kindness. It's a gift to the world and the best commemoration of a great leader, the late Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa. Hiba Abdul Ghaffar, Bahrain International.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa issued Edict 24 of the year 2019 and on adopting the 2019 annual report of the Education Quality and Training Authority. His Royal Highness also issued Edict 25 for the year 2019, amending some of the provisions of Edict 50 of the year 2015 regarding the establishment and formation of the Strategy and Coordination Committee of Frequency Spectrum. The text of Article 1 of Edict 50 of the year 2015 has been replaced with the following text. A committee designated the Strategy and Coordination for Frequency Spectrum Committee has been established hereinafter, referred to as the committee, presided by CEO of the Informatics and E-Government Authority and representative members from the following: Representative of the Wireless and Frequencies Licensing and Monitoring Directorate at the Informatics and E-Government Authority. The representatives of the Telecommunication and Directorate at the Ministry of Transportation and Telecommunications. Representative of the Seaports and Maritime Navigation Directorate at the Ministry of Transportation and the Telecommunications. Representative of the Civil Aviation Affairs at the Ministry of Transportation and Telecommunications. Representative of the Telecommunications Regulatory Authority. Representative of the National Security Agency. Representative of the Bahrain Defense Force. Representative of the Ministry of Interior. Representative of the National Guard. Representative of the Information Affairs Ministry. Representative of the National Space Science Agency. A new clause under the number 7 has been added to Article 3 of Edict 50 of the year 2015 as follows. Participation in the international meetings and conferences pertaining to frequency spectrum after coordination and follow-up with the concerned entities. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received the newly appointed ambassador of the State of Kuwait to the Kingdom of Bahrain, Sheikh Thamer Al Jaber Al Ahmed Al Sabah, at Ghudaybiyah Palace. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince emphasized the long-standing historic ties between Bahrain and Kuwait, which continues to thrive under the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah. The Crown Prince then welcomed the ambassador to the Kingdom of Bahrain, wishing him success in his diplomatic mission and in contributing to further enhancing bilateral relations between the two countries and their people. For his part, the Kuwaiti ambassador expressed gratitude for the opportunity to meet with His Royal Highness and highlighted His Royal Highness's support in further strengthening the Bahraini-Kuwaiti relations. The Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, also attended the meeting. On behalf of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa inaugurated the 18th Arab Businessmen and Investors Conference. The conference brings together decision makers to accelerate investment in entrepreneurship and innovation and fast-tracking digital transformation. Upon His Royal Highness's arrival, he was welcomed by the Chairman of the Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Samir Nas, and a number of BCCI board members. His Royal Highness affirmed that high-level of innovation have led to increased opportunities for citizens and to greater economic diversification in line with the vision of His Majesty the King. He reiterated that Bahrain's Economic Vision 2030 has enabled the kingdom to build on its strength, increasing investment flows and driving sustainable economic growth. His Royal Highness stressed that Bahrain will continue to implement initiatives and reforms that strengthen the business environment, enhance the kingdom's global competitiveness, and support the development of innovative business models. His Royal Highness went on to note that innovation and creativity safeguard the resilience of the national economy while supporting sustainable economic development. He noted that the kingdom had recently introduced legislation to keep global trends in IT infrastructure and creating promising new opportunities for citizens. His Royal Highness highlighted Bahrain's ongoing success as a host for international events, particularly those related to innovation, adding that events like ABIC enable national enterprises to compete on a global level. He concluded by expressing his appreciation to the BCCI for their efforts in organizing ABIC, wishing all participants success. BCCI chairman delivered a speech in which he recognized legislation, education, and IT infrastructure as essential pillars of the digital economy and noted the importance of establishing research centers to accelerate the region's transformation from a consumer to a competitive developer.
are setting the bar higher and higher for the ones that come after us. We want to put Bahrain on the map. We want to empower the youth. And we want to catch up with the new technologies. We want to catch up with the rest of the world. We want to wake up through this conference, the Arab world. We have youth that have the abilities, the intellectuals, to build of what these people ended up with.
I would like to congratulate the Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry for this very important anniversary. I think it's half a century of enormous successes and progress. And of course, especially the ABIC 2019. The ABIC 2019 is, I think, a wonderful milestone, which symbolizes the openness and the keen interest in technology which characterizes Bahrain. And I'm very happy that we have a German contribution to this, German panelists, which will participate in this very important event.
The BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa patronized a ceremony to honor BDF's military senior officers with medallions of distinction. The ceremony was attended by Defense Affairs Minister Lieutenant General Abdullah bin Hassan Al-Naimi. The Commander-in-Chief granted the medallions to the Chief of Staff Lieutenant General Diab bin Sagr Al-Naimi, National Security Advisor and Royal Guard Commander Major General His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and Commander of the Royal Guard Special Force Lieutenant Colonel His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the director of the Military Sports Association, Brigadier General Muhammad Abdul Latif bin Jalal, and Bahrain Football Association's President, Lieutenant Colonel Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa. Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa conveyed to them the greetings of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, wishing them continuous success in serving the kingdom. He stressed that the BDF has accomplished many honorable achievements in all fields, noting that it is moving steadily towards further progress and prosperity in various forms, thanks to the constant care of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Supreme Commander. Speaker of the Representatives Council Fozia Zainal chaired today the weekly meeting where the Council approved a draft law on establishing and regulating the Bahrain Authority for Tourism and Exhibition. The Council approved a proposal on establishing a private hospital to detect malignancies in the southern governorate and approved a report on speeding up the establishment of a health center in Bidaya, as well as a proposal to establish a service center in Muharraq. The Council also approved a report on the consideration by the Ministry of Electricity and Water Affairs of increasing the maximum time period of arrears from the bills of low-income households. The Council then approved formulating a parliamentary inquiry that looks into the causes of the economic and real estate recession, as well as ensure the fairness of distribution of housing applications. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa delegated the Southern Governor His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa to attend the graduation ceremony of Al Ahliya University's 14th batch, held in the presence of the university's Board of Trustees, members of the academic and administrative authorities, as well as the graduates' families. His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali conveyed the greetings of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister to the graduates and their families and his wishes of further success in their future endeavors. He affirmed that focusing on the educational sector and its development represents one of the government's main pillars in all its development programs and plans. He added that Bahrain takes pride in the development of the educational sector, which is in line with the kingdom's growth in various fields. The Southern Governor hailed the effective role of the private sector in supporting education in the kingdom, as it receives support from the government, which stems from its belief in its importance in enhancing the educational environment and providing the educational sector with the required resources. He noted the model Al Ahliya University presents in determination and perseverance to achieve the highest levels in national and international classifications. His Highness Sheikh Khalifa congratulated the graduates and their families, commending the efforts of the university's academic and administrative cadres. He asserted the importance of students' realization that graduation is not the end, but a beginning of a new stage that requires efforts and perseverance. The chairman of the Supreme Council for Islamic Affairs, Sheikh Abd al-Rahman bin Mohammed bin Rashid al-Khalifa, received the vice chairman of the Russian Shura Muftis Council and the religious departments of Russia, Sheikh Roshan Abbasov. Sheikh Abd al-Rahman bin Mohammed praised the relations between Bahrain and Russia and the development witnessed in all fields thanks to both countries' leaders. Sheikh Roshan expressed the council's pride in its strategic relations with the SCIA. He expressed thanks and appreciation to the SCIA's chairman for his role in enhancing the bilateral relations. The Minister of Education, Dr. Majid bin Ali Naimi, headed the Bahrain delegation participating in the 40th session of the UNESCO's General Conference held in Paris, France, with the participation of 193 member states, and in the presence of UN Secretary General, UNESCO's Director General, and senior officials and experts in the field of education, science, and culture. The conference discussed a number of important international topics, including the UNESCO 2015-2030 strategy and the extent to which the sustainable development goals, including the fourth, have been achieved. The opening session included the election of the president of the new general conference as well as the vice presidents, which included Bahrain. The minister attended the ministerial meeting, which discussed the recent international efforts to achieve sustainable development goal 4, affirming Bahrain's commitment to achieving it. He also pointed out that Bahrain has recently hosted the meeting of Arab ministers of education in cooperation with the Arab League Educational, Cultural and Scientific Organization, ALEXO, to discuss the Arab educational policy within the perspective of achieving the fourth goal. Naimi stressed Bahrain's support of UNESCO, considering it is a symbol of humanity and its keenness to achieve its noble goals. The minister also highlighted Bahrain's celebration of its formal education centennial. Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for the Environment, His Highness Sheikh Faisal bin Rashid Al Khalifa, affirmed that Bahrain's hosting of the Arab Businessmen and Investors Conference, which is being patronized by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, reflects His Majesty's keen interest in further developing business and investment in Bahrain. His Highness said that Vision 2030 guides Bahrain's engagement with the world of business and industrial investment, as is evident by the hosting of the conference, as well as its embrace of the Fourth Industrial Revolution in order to support for the youth and Bahraini women. His Highness affirmed pride in Bahrain's achievement in the fields of business and investment thanks to the support of His Majesty the King, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Highness also said that the conference is in line with the Supreme Council for the Environment's efforts, as it contributes to the government's efforts to achieve sustainable development through the cooperation between the public and private sectors, and that Bahrain, through its efforts, will remain a role model in the fields of economic development and investment.
I'll start by recognizing my profound appreciation to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, King of the Kingdom of Bahrain. His strength, guidance, and support for entrepreneurship and investment is steering the kingdom sustainably, diversifying our economy, and promoting national wealth to society.
The WEF 2019, the World Entrepreneurs Investment Forum, which goes in concurrent with the Arab Investor Summit number 18, it is the first time in the Arab country we bring investors and entrepreneurs to do business together. The theme is achieving the SDGs through innovation entrepreneurship and looking into the coming digital revolution and the fourth industrial revolution, how entrepreneurs in the Arab region, in Africa, in the world, they can be part of this coming digital revolution so that they can develop their enterprises related to innovation.
We're very proud as the United Nations to be here today supporting the WEF. It becomes at a very critical time right now as we are witnessing the impact of the fourth industrial revolution, where technology and knowledge is now moving ahead for the economy. Previously, it was based on natural resources. Now the economy is based on technology and knowledge. We're very happy to have UNIDO ITPO here organizing the WEF, where we bring a lot of people who actually embrace technology to do their business.
This is a very good conference we have, and it is the first time we have it in Bahrain for the entrepreneur investments. And this will tell you that, you know, that how the entrepreneur move in the countries, in the regions, in the world. So I think that this is something which we can learn from it, and I believe that this is something which we have it now for the past few years. We are trying to have it here in Bahrain, and I think that we succeed to hold this conference here in Bahrain.